All right. I love doing homework at 10 in the morning. Ah, 10 at night. I don't feel very stressed out for some reason. I mean, yeah, I definitely find accounting classes to be much more tolerable than the other business classes. Because it's like a lot of math stuff, but for some reason, this assignment we have to do, definitely not math related at all. It's just general accounting stuff here. It's really weird. I was talking about in the vlog, it just gives you a statement and then it says to comment on it. Like, I don't even know what you're supposed to say. I'm going to read the entire case and then read the questions again and see if I know what the heck I'm supposed to say. All it says is comment. What type of question is that? I haven't even read the chapter, but I feel like I should be fine just reading the case. It's not like I have to read the whole chapter to understand the case. Standard setting, a political aspect. This case consists of a letter from Dennis R. Burrisford, chairperson of the Financial Accounting Standards Board, to Senator Joseph I. Lieberman. A specific issue was proposed legislation relating to the accounting for employee stock options. It just tells you to comment on stuff. Like, what even is this? I love sniffing.
God. What is this assignment? I don't get this textbook. It just says, it gives you statements, and then you have to, it says comment. Comment? Comment what? That's not a question. That's not a question. What the heck? What? My cube on the bed that I'm using this terrible cube. Well, it would be easy to answer these four questions if they weren't written the way they were written. They just give you a statement and then they say a comment. What? I still can't get over these questions. I can't answer these questions. Comment. I just spit. Financial statements must provide a neutral scorecard of the effects of transactions. Comment. Dude, what do you want me to say? Comment what? Why? That you can write literally anything there, and it would technically be a comment. Comment about what? Well, comment about the statement. Write a comment relating to the statement we just gave you. In what way do you want me to comment on the statement? Why? This is the worst F2O case. The cube doesn't feel that slow, but still not as fast as it should be. You can't turn at full speed with this cube. Comments? Are you serious right now? The way you're asking these questions is just comment. Comment what? Costs of transactions exist whether or not the FASB mandates their recognition in financial statements. Comment. What? What do you want me to comment? I can't believe this. Ooh. Comment. Comment. I was not expecting to get this type of assignment for this type of class. I've never had something like this before in my entire life. Neutral statements must provide a neutral scorecard of the effects of transactions. Well,
the way the questions are written, it's giving you a lot of freedom.
As to what you write.
It just says to comment. It doesn't say what you're supposed to comment. It just says you're supposed to comment on the specific topic that they mentioned. Comment on this topic. Okay, I'll comment on it. Whatever you say, don't complain if my so-called comments aren't what you're looking for. You didn't specify what you wanted me to write, but you just said to comment, so too bad. It says you get two attempts. This cube actually feels a little fast, I think. well. Do we have like math questions and stuff? Are there gonna be math questions on our quiz? I might just switch to using this cube and see if it actually is finally fast after all this time. Probably not, but it feels kind of, it might be fast, I don't know. I'm trying to turn it quickly. Maybe it's fast for once. So... A. We need to save. Right. Case one. A. Am I supposed to comment? Man, I thought I had an idea of what to comment. Comments. Financial statement must provide a neutral scorecard of the effects of transactions. Is it charging? Oh, it's plugged in, but it's not charging. Apparently, unplugging and re-plugging it in somehow makes charge in 69 degrees outside. It feels hotter in here, though. It's really humid. I have fun being fat. So basically, there was a bunch of Snickers bars sitting on the table for like weeks, and I just couldn't just let it sit there forever. So I ate all the Snickers bars. Oh man, we no longer have any dessert here. So, oh, gosh. I want. So probably after I do this homework and whatnot, I'm going to go downstairs and eat leftover brats. That's like the closest thing to dessert that we have It's gonna be weird. Why would I eat another meal? I already had 3 meals. I had Cheerios for breakfast. Well, the second meal wasn't really much of a meal. It was just a bag of popcorn and a bag of chips. And then the third meal was 2 hamburgers and some grapes. And then I'm gonna eat a fourth meal, apparently, by eating 2 brats. Because I want dessert, but that's the only, that's the closest thing to dessert that we had. Man, I hate this assignment. It says to comment. What the heck? Dude. Comment, what? you're just stating things. You're just stating ideas. And then you're asking me to comment on those ideas. Comment what? About the idea. That's not a question, dude. That's not a question. Oh my gosh. That's not a question. Financial I don't even care anymore. Oh,
Thank you.
It just said comment. That'd be hilarious if he gave me a bad grade. And it's like, you didn't do it right. I wonder if I'm gonna bomb that test. I'm gonna kind of skim over the three chapters. Three. Yeah, I'm not reading all three chapters. Well, tomorrow we have homework. So we do have the online thingy for this. Wait, what? It's a quiz. You get two attempts. What the heck is this? Homework chapter 2. What are we supposed to do on that? Is it like a quiz? Well, let's do tomorrow. I seriously wonder if I'm gonna bomb this quiz.
I don't have any clue how well I'm gonna do on this. I don't know if he's gonna ask math questions, if it's conceptual questions. I haven't read these chapters at all. These chapters are kind of long. Let's see the length of these chapters. Chapter 1 starts on page 1. Chapter 2 starts on page 54. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. But let's... Okay, page 1, 2, 32. So it's really 32 pages. And then there's 20 pages of problems? What? How are there that many questions in this book? There's 20 pages of... 20 pages of questions. What? Questions. They're all word questions, or they're all paragraphs, or I don't know what you call it. This is a lot of questions. So there's a bunch of questions, then we have problems. Place the appropriate letter identifying each quality on the line. So basically, what the heck? Dude, I'm probably gonna bomb this test. Multiple choice questions? Dude. Which of the following is a characteristic of information provided by external financial reports? I would say it's 2. The information is frequently the result of reasonable estimates. I love how they have a none of the above answer for a lot of the questions. It's so dumb. Oh yeah, the quality of relevance. Well, that's tough. But man, these chapters are so long. Oh, I want to read through the rest of the questions. Tons of multiple choice questions. What? I've only gotten through like a couple of the pages. Oh, maybe it's not all questions. It's like cases. It's cases. That's the one I just submitted. Case one. Two, case one, one, case one, two, case one, three, case one, four, case one, five, case one, six, case one, seven, case one, eight, case one, nine, case one, ten, case one, 11, case 114, web case. To the neck case. And that's it. Man. Anyway. So chapter 1 is 30 pages of reading. Let's check chapter 2. Okay, chapter 2 goes from 54. I'm not going to include the questions and cases. Chapter 2 goes from 54... to 73. So it's about 20 pages actually. And maybe they're not as long as I thought, but it just includes so much other material and stuff. That's why it's so long. Chapter 3 is from 95 to 1. Oh man, that's 35 pages. So we have a 35, a 20. At 30. Man. So basically an average of 30 pages, well, a little bit less than that, per chapter. And each page is filled with words. There's so many words on each page. Giant long paragraphs of content. Imagine if I was just to read through the entire thing. Yeah, like I'm actually gonna do it. I wish there was a better summary of it. The summaries are terrible. They barely provide any information. Using the internet? What the heck? The internet is a global collection of companies, internet websites, helpful websites. This is a long, dense textbook right here. The summary of the chapter, the summary of chapter one. Wait just a second. Chapter one only goes to page 24. What? I thought it went to page 30. Hold on a second, I'm confused. Chapter one. Where did I get the idea that it goes to page 30? It must just because I'm dumb. Because it does, it goes to page 24. Where did I get that idea from that it goes to page 30? So chapter 1 is actually only 24 pages, not 30 pages. So we have a 24, a 9, Actually, chapter 2 is only 19 pages. So we have a 24 page, a 19 page, and a 35 page chapter. And the chapter 1 summary this chapter has reviewed the development of U.S. generally accepted accounting principles and the traditional assumptions of the accounting model. You need a broad understanding of GAAP and the traditional assumptions to reasonably understand financial reports. The financial reports can be no better than the accounting principles and the assumptions of the accounting model that are the basis for preparation. This chapter introduced harmonization of international accounting standards and financial reporting standards for small and medium-sized entities. It also introduced helpful websites that can be very useful when performing analysis. That is not a summary, dude. That is not a summary. Well, it is, but it was like, we talked about this, 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 and this. That's not what I was looking for. But I was looking for the information you provided, but just in a very summarized fashion. No. I was looking for, like, actual information, not what you guys tell me, but what you're going to tell me in a shorter, summarized fashion. I don't know. This book is so old. Copyright 2013. Eight years old. Apparently, it was written by Charles H. Gibson. Written by one person. I love sniffing. I'm gonna skip. I've kind of been reading through the first chapter, but I'm just gonna skip to chapter 3 because we went over chapter 2 PowerPoint, and did we go through the PowerPoint of chapter 1 last week? I don't even remember. Chapter 3, balance sheet. I know what a balance sheet is. I know the accounting equation. My God, look at this textbook. It's weird. This textbook doesn't talk about the statement of stockholders' equity. I don't know why. Or the statement of common equity, I don't remember what it's called, but why doesn't it talk about that? What? Oh, it does. I don't know why it's a secondary statement here. I thought it was one of the main four statements. It's so weird how it's like demoted to not being as important, because it's like the principal ones are these three, and then there's also this one. Why don't you just list all four as the main statements? What? Like, they don't even have a whole chapter dedicated to it. They have whole chapters dedicated to the three other ones, and then the stockholders' equity one, they just crammed into the balance sheet chapter. Time to sniff. Whoa. Is this an example balance sheet? It says it's a consolidated balance sheet. What is a consolidated balance sheet?
I don't know why some textbooks have way more information than others. Like, my previous accounting textbooks were much easier to read, had way less stuff in them.
But no, this one has so much stuff.
Very small text. And the text... well, they leave a large gap on the left side of the page for some reason. I'm not sure why. Like, what's that gap even for? But anyways, it's mostly text. There's very few pictures in this book. Basically no pictures at all. It's just text. I don't know why some textbooks like having pictures and some just don't have any pictures at all.
What's the difference between these?
I don't like this definition of assets. They describe it as probable future economic benefits obtained or controlled by an entity as a result of past transactions or events. I don't know. It's really weird how they word it.
if we have to do one of the questions involving the various methods of depreciation, I'm probably going to fail those questions. If it's the straight line method, I'll be fine. But if it's a declining balance method, I'm screwed. There's also sum of the year's digits method. What? What? That's weird. If it's, there's like four methods in here of depreciation. Imagine going through all this effort to actually try to study, and it's going to be all for nothing. There's way too much stuff. I can't possibly read all of it. I'm just reading some of it here. Going through every single stinking possible thing on the balance sheet. Liability, current liability, payable, unearned income, other current liability, long-term liability, liability relating to financing agreements, notes payable, bonds payable, credit agreement, deferred taxes, warranty obligation. Non-controlling interest. Other non-current liabilities. Redeemable preferred stock. Then we have stockholders' equity. Paid in capital. Common stock, preferred stock, accumulation of dividends. Quasi reorganization. A company with a deficit balance and retained earnings starts over with a zero balance
my gosh. What? Treasury stock, stockholders' equity, and unincorporated funds. What about unincorporated funds? What the what? I think this got screwed up. What the heck? What is this textbook? This page right here doesn't make any sense. Chapter 1 and 2. I'm just going to read the headings of chapter 1 and 2. That's what I did for most of chapter 3 just now. It describes every single one of those things. I can't even finish this. This sucks. I can't. I've barely read any of the 3 chapters. So, I wonder what grade I'm gonna get on my quiz.